Hi guys, welcome back to interview session. Okay, here we are discussing about the most interesting and frequently and most important every interview. When you are getting in your resume, you have skills on core Java and automation testing. Compulsory, most of the people asking this type of question. That question is nothing but a Fibonacci series. Today we are going to writing the program and explaining the each and line to line. What is this numbers? How internally program will be executed? Now let us see. Program is okay. Now before that program, what is this Fibonacci series number? Fibonacci series numbers is adding the number with existing numbers. Now let us see, it will start from the 0, 1, and to get in the next number it should be adding the 0 plus 1 equal to 1. To get the next number it will add in the 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Getting the another number 1 plus 2 equal to 3. Getting the another number 2 plus 3 equal to 5. To get the another number and 3 plus 5 equal to 8. Okay, to get the another number 5 plus 8 equal to 30. Like that, to get next number we need to go through the 21 with adding the existing numbers. And now here is the simple tricky. When we are understanding the logical, we don't need to go through that much of tricky. We can make it easy. Okay, now let us go through the program. Here I am declaring the class. Class is Fibonacci numbers. And here I am going through the main method. Now let us see, here I am declaring int a equal to 0. First two numbers are static. Before getting the second number, we are need to get the first two numbers is static. Start from a, 0 starting from 0, and b equal to 1. And then here I am declaring c is null. And here I am getting a n. N equal to, if the interviewer asking print the starting 10 Fibonacci series numbers, we can make it as a number as 10. If the interviewer asking print starting 100 numbers, we can make it as a N equal to 100. Okay, this is the N value declaration. Now I need a starting from 1 to 10 Fibonacci series numbers. So this is the code. Here I am going through the, before that we need to know the definition of print and println. Print for which execution it is? Horizontal execution. Print for horizontal execution, print for vertical. So ln means next line, it will be printing. When we are using this println, after this line it will be coming to the next line. Okay, when we are giving this print, it should be going through the senior linear execution. Now here I am going through the system dot out dot print a plus space plus b. It will be execute that 0, 1, and again we need to go through the for loop. Already two numbers was printed. Now int I equal to 3, I less than or equal to 10. So this loop will be executing 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This loop will be executed 8 times. When I am getting here plus plus. Okay, already completed 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, it will be executed 8 times. Why? Because already we have printed 2 numbers. Now, C equal to A plus B. C equal to A plus B. Now what is the C value? A value is 0 plus B value is 1. So C value is 1. C value is 1. So that system dot out dot print. Print space plus C. Why? Because after here it was executed 0 and 1. After that it will execute in space and after that C value is 1. Okay. Now here it will be getting the answer as here we are getting the 0 space 1. Here we are getting the 1. Why? Because C equal to A plus B. And after that A equal to B, B equal to C. Now loop was closed. Now loop was closed. And again here I am closing the main method and closing the class. Now let us see, class was opened here, class was closed here. Method was opened here, method was closed here. Loop was opened here, loop was closed here. Now let us see, what is the execution? When I am running this program, my output is, my output, I am getting the 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8 and 13 and 21 and 32. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the first 10 Fibonacci series number. These are the first 10 Fibonacci series number. Now, this is the program. Anyone can write. But we need to go through the explanation. What is that explanation? Well, here we are using this loop for just looping purpose only. Here we are not using this I value. Loop number 1, it will get in that 1. And after the, here we are given a equal to B. Now, what is B value? B value is 1. So, A equal to 1. So, A equal to 1. And after that, what is B value? B equal to C. What is the C value here? C value is 1. So, B value also 1. Now, in coming to the loop number 1, loop number 1, A equal to 0, B equal to 1. Coming to the loop number 2, and C equal to 1. And coming to the loop number 2, again, we are told that A equal to B. So, A equal to 1. And again, we are telling B equal to C. So, B equal to 1. It will change in the numbers. It will change in the numbers automatically. And now we are getting C equal to what we are told here. C equal to A plus B. Now, A plus B equal to 1 plus 1 equal to 2. We are getting the value is 2. And after that, another loop it will follow. Now let us see, A equal to B. B means what is the B value here? B value is 1. So A equal to 1. We are told that B equal to C. B equal to C. What is the C value here? C value is 2. So B equal to 2. And again C equal to A plus B. Now 1 plus 2 equal to 3. So we are getting a 3. And another loop, we are told that A equal to B. A equal to B means, so B value is already we have got that 2. So, A equal to 2. And we are told that B equal to C. What is the C value? C value is 3. So, B equal to 3. And C equal to A plus B. Now, let us see, 2 plus C equal to 5. 2 plus C equal to 5. Here I am told that this is the program executing multiple times. Now 5. We have got 5. And another loop. A equal to B. So A value. What is the A value? So previously B equal to 3. So B. A equal to B. So B A converting into 3. And B equal to C. So B converting as a C value. C equal to 5. And C equal to A plus B. Now let us see, what is the C value? 3 plus 5 equal to 8. Again it converting into, again loop converting into A equal to 5 and B equal to 8. Now we are getting a C equal to 8 plus 5 13, 8 plus 5, 13. And again, loop number, again loop A equal to, what is the B value? 8. And what is the, now B value is, what is the C? 13. Now we are getting a 21. Finally, loop number, A equal to 13 and B equal to 21. So we are getting a 32. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 loops was completed. And after that, I will be converting 11. I will be converting 11. In this time, 11 is not less than or equal to 10. So condition will be false. So this is the execution of each and every loop. Each and every loop, this is the execution. Here it will follow simply starting from A equal to 0, B equal to 1. So C equal to 1. C equal to 1. Each and every time C will be printed. Before that, A equal to 0 already printed, B equal to 1 already printed. Now C equal to 1. Again, we know that A will be converting into B value. So A equal to 1, B equal to 1. So C equal to 2. And again, A equal to 1, B equal to 2, so C equal to 3. And again, A equal to 2, B equal to 3, so C equal to 5. And again, A equal to 3, B equal to 5, C equal to 8. And again, A equal to 5, because of A equal to B, we told them. So B equal to 8. And C equal to 13. And again, A equal to 8, B equal to 13, so C equal to 21. And again, A equal to 13, B equal to 21, so C equal to 32. This is our execution. 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 32. These are the starting 10 Fibonacci series numbers. If the interviewer asks that print starting 100 Fibonacci series numbers, just we can keep here 100, then automatically you can keep n also here. When the interviewer asks 100, then don't change here, just change n equal to 100. Before not using 100, you can go through direct here 10, no problem. Okay, now we can keep n here, we can print starting 100 Fibonacci series also. Okay guys, this is the program. This program will be making some tricky, but when you have understand the logic, it is a very simple program. And when we have a 100% probability, in 90% of probability, they are asking this Fibonacci series number. So this is the program and this is the explanation internally. Internally, JVM will collect this type of data and we can see in a neat way this line, and this is the program. And after that, we can make it very possible. And when you are writing this type of programs, it will build your confidence. When it will be encouraging to you before to trying some more like this type of programs. Okay, and all the best. Thank you for the watching.